One of the biggest challenges I faced with creating product animation is making multiple product variations. It all really comes down to time, especially when you're working with 3D. It can become a very long process. So today I'm going to show you a workflow which will allow you to generate multiple 3D product variations and control them all natively within After Effects. We're going to do this by using the new Adobe Illustrator-to-Substance 3D Painter support features. In a nutshell, this means you can essentially drag and drop your Illustrator files directly into Painter and then instantly swap out to any of the labels and designs that you set up. From there, we're going to send those models directly into After Effects, and we're going to animate together a product commercial. So let's get started by designing the look and feel of our 3D products. If you're looking for a great place to start, I recommend checking out the Adobe Substance 3D Asset Library. There's nearly 20,000 fully licensed, professionally created materials, models, and IBL lights that you can use in your projects. There's even an integrated connection directly within Substance Painter. So if you want, you can download all your assets directly from that window in the software. So as an example for this tutorial, I'm going to download a few chocolate bar models, as well as some foil and chocolate materials from the Substance 3D library. Once I have that all set up and ready to go, we're going to work on our chocolate designs. So let's hop into Adobe Illustrator. I found these luxury chocolate vector designs from Adobe stock. So I'm just going to go ahead and open those up. Now the key here is to make sure every design is within its own artboard. So over on the left here, click to create a new artboard and place each design into an artboard. Make sure as you're doing that in the properties, you label the artboards appropriately because we're going to be changing between them later. I'm also going to create a final artboard here and drag in a bunch of miscellaneous labels and barcode graphics, which I can use to just add some final small details later on. So now we're ready to work on the 3D model itself in Substance Painter. Let's go ahead and create a new project here, and I'm going to open up that chocolate bar model that we downloaded earlier. Now, I've already optimized the UVs for this model beforehand, but if you want, you can set up your UVs all within Substance Painter by selecting the auto unwrap options here. Let's set packaging to recompute all, and there you go. Now we're ready to apply our Illustrator designs directly to our model. I want to use one of those foil textures that we downloaded as a sort of base material. So let's go ahead and just load those in and then apply them to our chocolate bar. Now we can add in our custom designs. So again, all you have to do is drag and drop that Illustrator file directly into Substance Painter. Now I want to mix this design with our already existing foil material. So I'm going to go down here to the properties, and in the material settings, I'll disable everything except for the color channel. That will allow you to create these hybrid combinations of your custom designs and any other material you can think of. Now keep in mind, from here, you can make any other design changes you like. For example, with my chocolate bar here, I want to add a bit of a paper texture at the top to separate the label from the foil. So I'm going to create a new fill layer, click here to create a black mask, and then I'm going to search for a paper texture. We can drag that onto the fill layer, and now you can simply use your brush tool to choose where you want that paper texture. Just make sure you drag your custom graphic layer to the very top of the stack. And now that we have our first product design set up, this is the best part. Under properties, you have this new file type specific settings dropdown. This allows you to easily swap to any of the product variation designs that we set up as an artboard in Illustrator. So if you're ever tight on time, you need to produce a bunch of variations, you can go over to this option, swap them out in one click, and then render them out here or send them to your 3D software of choice. Now we're almost finished here. Before we go ahead and start exporting and animating, I want to add a couple fine details. If you remember earlier, we set up that miscellaneous artboard in Illustrator. Now, if you want, you could have taken those labels and other small details and custom placed them on your artboard designs, but I instead prefer to put them all into their own artboard so that we can isolate them and make any changes on the fly if needed. So for example, let's go ahead and duplicate our original labels layer. In the file specific settings, we can switch to the miscellaneous labels artboard just to see all of them. And then I'll position the label UVs where I want them, and then I'll go up to the top right and add a black mask. We can then mask out just that label, so we have only this label isolated in its own layer. This is great for, again, changing things on the fly. For example, I like how this looks on the caramel packaging, but on the dark chocolate design, maybe you think the nutrition facts are a little bit hard to see. So to fix this, I can click on the wand icon, I can add a levels effect, and then click invert. And just like that, you have some easy on-the-fly custom control for each of those variations. So I thought that was worth mentioning in case you do need it. Again, you can repeat those steps to add in the rest of your other details or labels. Once you are finished, let's get ready to start animating. I want to create a commercial with a bunch of different elements. So I want an actual candy bar. I want the chocolate bar in the wrapping. And I also want a combination of the two where it's a half wrap chocolate. So let's create some final variations that we can use. I'm going to create a new Substance Painter project. And this time I'll open up one of the chocolate bar without the packaging models that we downloaded from the Substance asset library. I also downloaded a few chocolate bar textures, so let's drag and drop those onto our bar model. And this is really cool. A benefit of Substance materials is they are parametric as opposed to being flat bitmap textures. So this means a lot of these materials have custom parameters that can let you do some unique things. So in this case, with our chocolate material, we can change the pattern, the thickness, and we can even control how many chunks of the chocolate are bitten away. So pun intended, that's pretty sweet. I love all these materials that just have those niche things that you can change with Substance. So go ahead, have fun, create those different set pieces. Once you're all ready, we're going to go up to File, and you can either export these to your 3D software or you can send them directly to After Effects. I personally am going to do this in After Effects, but I do want to make that final little combination where you can see the chocolate bar in the wrapper. So I'm going to switch over to Blender and just combine the two. The nice thing about Painter and Substance materials, everything is very interchangeable. It's going to look the same once you transfer it to whatever 3D software you want. I want this model in After Effects, so I'm just going to export it as a GLB. For the rest of our models and variations, I'm just going to send those directly to After Effects using this option here. So now we have all of these different 3D product designs all within After Effects. We're ready to start animating them together. First off, we need to set up our lighting and our 3D environment. So I'm going to go back to the Substance 3D library and search for an environment light. We can download that and then drag the file directly into After Effects. And then to actually apply it, we're going to right click in our composition. We're going to create a new light and we're going to set it to environment. And then in that environment light under source, you can select the HDRI file that we placed in our composition. You guys can change the intensity and rotate the light here to get the lighting setup that you like best. For the background, I'll keep it simple. I'll create a colored solid and then I'm going to create a shape layer on top of it. I'll add a repeater to that shape layer just to kind of create this swirl pattern. After that, I'm going to add a gradient here and I'll change the blending mode just to mix those two together. With a little bit of rotation keyframes and some noise on the top, we have a nice animated swirly retro background. I'm also going to add in a camera, just right click new camera, and I'll animate it just to zoom forward flying past our chocolate bars. I thought it'd be really cool to create a transition as we fly past the chocolate. So I'm just going to keyframe the opacity of our background layer to fade out as we fly through. Once it's faded out, I'll just drag in another background here. And now we can add in our three product variations. Pro After Effects tip when dealing with 3D layers or any layers for that matter, you can set up the positioning of one variation the way you like, then drag in the next variation. And instead of repositioning everything by hand in 3D space, you can just select the transform option for the first one you set up, click Control C, then select the transform on the next variation, click Control V, and there you go. You can just move this one over and they're gonna match up in 3D space perfectly. So I'm going to offset the layers so that they pop in one after the other. The layers should look like a staircase ascending up. As finishing touches, I'll also add some overlay elements like chocolate chunks, as well as some of these swirls. Remember to take full advantage when working with 3D layers when you do this. You can go to the compositing options of any of these objects and enable or disable shadows for added realism. And just like that, we have a really cool little 3D product variation animation. Now you can do things like Illustrator and Substance, Substance to After Effects, and it's just giving you a simplified relationship to ease your workflow and control everything along the way. So hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, leave a like on it, subscribe for more videos like this. I'll see you guys in the next one.